สวัสดีค่ะ and good afternoon. Welcome back to the English language summary of the daily press briefing on the COVID-19 situation live from the Center for COVID-19 Situation Administration, or the CCSA. For today's briefing, which is Saturday, the 5th of June 2021, allow me to start with the general situation, the overall picture, and the number of new confirmed cases. We have today reported 2,817 new cases. Out of this number, 1,295 cases were reported from healthcare facilities, which means that these were patients who had symptoms and walked in to have their tests and were received positive tests. There are also within this number 1,151 cases from active case findings, and 315 cases were from penitentiaries, and 49 from international arrivals who are contained within the state quarantine system. So that leaves us with a total number of active cases right now at 49,490. We have today, as Dr. Tuisin just reported to us just now, a number of severe symptoms. These are cases with lung inflammation. These are 1,195 cases, and 361 cases within that number are on ventilators, and the majority of these cases are being treated in Bangkok. We have today a new number of new recoveries, which is a good news to say because they exceed the number of new confirmed cases. So the new recoveries today we have standing at 3,396 cases. So the new total number of recoveries today we have 124,093 cases, excuse me. Of course, I have to report to you, unfortunately, very regretfully, we have new fatalities standing at 36 cases. And that leaves us with a cumulative total of fatalities standing at 1,213 cases. And most of these fatalities occurred in Bangkok, which is reported to have 16 new fatalities today. And the age range of the fatalities today is between 24 and 92 years of age, with the median age at 68 years old. And most of the fatalities today had contracted the virus from their family members, their colleagues and friends, or their close contacts, or from high-risk areas. And the CCSA wishes to extend their most deepest condolences to the families and friends of the deceased. Today, the highest number of cases reported at the provinces remains in Bangkok. Bangkok has 925 cases. Pathum Thani has 411 cases. Samut Sakhon has 293 cases. Samut Prakan at 143 cases. And Phetchaburi at 130 cases. And the new observations today, which was discussed at the CCSA daily operational meeting, the Department of Disease Control reported new clusters in factories in the province of Samut Sakhon, Prachuap Kirikan, Phetchaburi, and Trang, and also a new cluster in Lat Krabang district of Bangkok. And also a new cluster has been detected in several department stores in Siam Square, area within the district of Pathum Wan in Bangkok, with the total number of confirmed cases standing at 144, and these were detected from active case findings. Apart from observing disease control measures, the CCSA also wanted to emphasize the importance of factory employers and employees to strictly implement quality control standards, which should be in accordance with good factory practice, or GFP, as advised by the Ministry of Public Health. And this is to help effectively reduce the risk of infections within the factories and also for the greater good of the public health. Also, infections in fresh markets remain low, with only 7 new cases detected among market vendors within the last 24 hours. This is the good news that we want to send out and encourage people that your efforts actually have made good fruits, have borne good fruits. And we'd like to credit this to all the market vendors and their management staff, as well as customers who have strictly complied with the DMHTT practices, which has now resulted in preventing transmission of the virus in high-risk areas. We hope this trend will continue, and we encourage all to follow this very good example. However, there are cases that are still being detected from people who enter the country via border checkpoints and natural border crossings. And today, the CCSA received reports from the Border Patrol Police and security officials that they were able to identify 225 people who crossed the border illegally as of yesterday. And therefore, we'd like to stress, as the CCSA has consistently emphasized, that people should enter the country via designated border checkpoints by cooperating with related authorities, and they should follow instructions and disease control measures, and everyone is obligated to enter state quarantine systems for their own safety as well as for the collective public health safety. I'd like to now move forward to talk about our national vaccine campaign and to see what new developments we have made. Yesterday, the Ministry of Public Health reported that nationwide, more than 180,000 doses of vaccine have been administered. This brings the total of number of doses inoculated to over 4 million. This is an important benchmark for our national vaccination drive. So with 6 million more doses of vaccines due to be delivered within this month of June, Thailand should be able to achieve the vaccination target of 10 million doses by the end of June, as we have planned. And the Ministry of Public Health is confident that they will be able to achieve the goal of administering 100 million doses of vaccines by the end of this year. And to date, the government has already secured the procurement of 67 million doses of vaccine. And within this week, the agreements to order 25 million doses from Pfizer and Johnson & Johnson will be finalized. We are now at the beginning of the largest vaccination campaign in the history of our nation, while we're also combating with the largest outbreak since the pandemic has begun. This vaccination campaign involves various public and private agencies and is also being adjusted through time, with the time as the situation evolves. I wish to express our sincerest appreciation for the questions as well as concerns raised by many foreign nationals regarding this issue. For us, this means that foreign nationals are prepared to cooperate and to work with the Thai government, with us, and receive vaccinations through any of the options that we are making available. However, there are concerns about how many hospitals. Some hospitals have not indicated their readiness to administer vaccines. And of course, these are all valid questions and concerns. And please allow me to clarify initially that the Ministry of Public Health has been communicating and consulting with the provinces and the designated vaccination centers and hospitals, and we will share their plans with you as soon as this is available. It is our interest to make sure that as many people are vaccinated as soon as possible so we can meet our target of 70% of the population inoculated by the end of 2021. And this will help us achieve herd immunity. And therefore, your cooperation and readiness to work with us, raising concerns with us, flagging us and telling us and giving us recommendations as well in achieving this goal is greatly appreciated. So before I close today, allow me to mention that today is World Environment Day, which the United Nations has designated to encourage worldwide awareness and action for the environment, to conserve our very, very valuable environment. And one of the easiest ways to help the environment during COVID-19 is to manage your waste and recycling as responsibly as possible and to leave as little footprint on the earth as possible. And to keep waste collectors safe, please remember washing recyclable waste such as plastic bottles before disposing them, and to place biohazard waste such as face masks and gloves in a separate container. So these are all the updates I have for you today. Thank you very, very much for your kind attention. Have a good rest of the day and a good weekend. And don't forget to practice DMHTTA. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณค่ะ สวัสดีค่ะ
ครับ ขอบคุณนะครับ คุณ